My main elements would be bass kick scratch, where it's or, you know, you could do different types of ways of, you know what I mean, to flip it like that. And then, like when you were saying with the words, with the, and then, you know, you put it together. One, two.
You have this amazing talent that people go, wow,
it's kind of a circus trick.
Beatboxing. It's a blessing and a curse.
Something a lot more serious than just like a gimmick.
A legitimate vocal art form. I want increasing visibility of beatboxing. The four elements of hip-hop: MCing, b-boying, turntablism, and graffiti. They call beatboxing the fifth element. It's tough. When you're a beatboxer, it's a blessing and a curse, because you have this, if you're good at what you do, you have this amazing talent that people go, wow! But then also, there's this danger that you become this novelty, like, oh, look at, he can make all these sound effects and he can imitate that, and isn't that cute? But you're not taken seriously as an artist.
USA er hiphopens hjemland. Undergrunnskulturen vokste fram I New York, men spredte seg raskt fra østkysten til resten av landet. Hiphop-elementet av rap og DJing har satt sterke spreg på populærkulturen. Men I San Francisco har et mindre anerkjent element fått en sterk posisjon. Human beatbox.
Come on in.
Kid Bion en banebrytende beatboxer som har vakt internasjonal oppsikt.
This is my kitchen, studio, living room, breakfast room, second bedroom, small apartment.
Han også en av ildsjelene I en viktig bevegelse som inspirerer hele beatbox-verdenen.
We started the Vowel Movement 3 years ago in a small club in San Francisco. We are known as one of the places where the art form is really thriving and being kept alive and being taken into new directions.
The Vowel Movement arrangerer festivaler, konserter og klubbkvelder hvor unge talent får vise seg fram og etablerte beatboxere kan prøve ut nye ideer.
I can make my mistakes in front of a crowd that's gonna, you know, show me some love. So then when I open for Keen or a bigger artist or, you know, when I open for someone else, I'm not making my mistakes there. I can do it in front of my home crowd.
Bobby, I don't know. But whatsoever I play, it's got to be excellent.
We're really providing a space for people to try out new stuff.
You don't know the state I'm in.
We've created a community around beatboxing. It's really beautiful. And in the future, you know, we're going to put out albums and videos and, you know, who knows, scholarships. And so really the sky's the limit.
Introduce this next performer. This man is a historian of the art form. Beatboxing is this man's entire life.
It is my honor and pleasure to introduce from New York City, Kid Lucky.
Miserable day, yeah. Miserable day. Miserable day, yeah.
Human beatboxing started in New York. You know what I'm saying? Plain and simple. You know, we're not saying that it's the first vocal music. we're saying this particular style, this particular technique, you know what I mean, came out in New York City. In the, you know, in the first recording is like 1983, 82.
Party people, if you're ready to rock, let me hear you scream!
I 1984 fikk ungdom over hele verden øynene opp for hiphop-kulturen da filmen Beat Street gikk på kino. De fire elementene, rapping, DJing, breakdancing og graffiti ble introdusert, og var plutselig det kuleste ungdom verden over kunne drive med.
Everybody clap! Now here's a funky beat!
Beat Street var også direkte årsak til at et femte element innen hiphop begynte å blomstre. Denne scenen med pioneren Dougie Fresh var det første verden så av Human Beatbox. Dougie Fresh, you know that kid from down the block?
To me, always, the two that will be the greatest in my mind will be Dougie Fresh and Buff.
Filmen Krush Groove introduserte den andre store foregangsmannen, Buff, fra gruppa The Fat Boys, I midten her. Scenen med Buff bidro sterkt til å gi beatboxinga et ansikt.
Look, man, we're rappers, the Disco 3. We're supposed to perform here tonight.
We never heard of y'all.
What is you crazy, man? You never heard of us, the Disco 3? We're known everywhere. Yo, Buff, give him a taste, man.
They were there in the beginning, and they were pioneers and creators. And to me, like, being the, you know, the best out there isn't just being like that person who's now currently on top. It's the person who came out and said, it's this, I am this, you know what I mean? And I'm going to give this to the world. And everybody goes, oh, I want to do that. I want to do that. I want to do that.
Fat Boys sin nyutgivelse av The Twist ble en stor hit I 1988, og beatboxing var en del av populærkulturen. Buff var sammen med Dougie Fresh en enorm inspirasjonskilde for den kommende generasjonen beatboxere.
It comes from like, you know, a mixture of like a little bit of like not having the equipment. But more so, it comes from here.
Cause I remember one, at first they wasn't.
Biz Markie, en beatboxer og rapper fra New York, fulgte tett I Buff og Dougie Fresh sine fotspor, men på slutten av 80-tallet forsvant beatboxingen fra mainstream-kulturen og ned I undergrunnen. Ikke før I 1999 ble Human Beatbox brakt på bana igjen, da amerikaneren Rahzel ga ut sitt første soloalbum, Make Music 2000. Han lamslo musikkverden med tette rytmer, lydeffekter og imitasjon av scratching. Rahzel hadde markert seg som medlem av hiphop-bandet The Roots tidligere, men med den nye plata ble han den viktigste inspirasjonskilden for nye talent over hele verden.
I would say like the scene in America is it's back again. It's about to be a whole lot stronger than it was in the 80s. Definitely it's stronger now than it was in the 90s as a collective movement. And in Europe just started, you know. So the scene as a whole is getting much bigger.
The Vowel Movement har 3-årsjubileum og arrangerer en festival hvor de har hentet en av de største beatbox-mesterne. Publikum skal oppleve artisten som kaller seg den menneskelige DJ, Scratch.
I'm just glad to be a part of events like this because I mean I've been doing this all my life and then to see it grow the way it's been growing in the industry and starting to be taken on as something a lot more serious than just like a gimmick and being treated as an art form and to be here and be acknowledged in the position that I'm in, I just feel proud and very thankful.
I had never met Scratch before. I'd heard his work on record and heard of him, and to see him perform live amazing. An insane beatboxer. First of all, incredibly powerful. Just brought this power, just the sheer force with which his voice attacked the mic. Amazing. And then, of course, I mean, there's a reason he's called Scratch. Like, his vocal turntablism, insane. You know, the, I can't even do it. Right? I can't do it, you know. That thing that he has, maybe it's in the back of his... I want to, like, look in line at his throat and see, what are you doing, man, with his... Can't do it, you know?
When I was about 7 or 8 years old, it was a DJ that lived like about 4 or 5 doors down from me. And I remember when scratching was first starting to become like a thing, because before, years ago, like the DJs would just mix 2 songs together and then do the fade, you know, and that was like, oh, he killing it, that's the best DJ around here, nobody doing it like him. And then when scratching came around, I just was like amazed by the sound of how a record will go back and forth, and then you can start to be able to create a rhythmic flow to it over a track. So it also starts to become like another instrument. And one day when I heard it, I went back home and just started doing it. And it wasn't like something that like I had to sit in my room and practice, like I gotta get it right. It was more of, it came natural to me. That's a little James Brown thing. Let me get up and do my thing. And then, let me get up and do my thing. You know what I'm saying? And then, and just thinking of the speed and style of how it would sound if a DJ was actually pulling it back and forth. And I just want to make it sound a little flow, a little better, and then play with it as I do it. You know, giving it like a little shaky sound or whatever. You know, but don't put me too much on the spot. Some people forget that they're watching someone doing it with their vocals. They're more like in tune to like the sound, and you know, I like to be theatrical with it. I turn the whole thing into a party instead of just like, watch me and let me try to educate you, because people have like short time span nowadays, so you know, you gotta hit them with it. It's like I have a 10-15 second factor. It's like, if you don't grab them in the first 10-15 seconds, it's gonna be very hard for you the rest of the way, you know?
Både Scratch og Kid Beyond tar I bruk teknologi som utvider mulighetene for beatboxing på scenen. Kid Beyond har utviklet en avansert form for live looping som har bidratt til å føre beatboxing I nye retninger.
What I have here, I have a foot pedal, and the foot pedal allows me to talk to the computer while I'm on stage without having to touch the computer to type things and move a mouse around. So actually there's not a lot going on in here, a lot of it is happening in here. It's like I pre-produce the song before I perform it. And so I'm pouring live audio into each track, and each track already has its effects on it. So for example, yeah. So we have one loop, right? Now we're gonna add 2 loops, right? So now we have 3 or 4 loops. Now some bass, right? Now we got some bass. Now I'll add some synths on top. Now another one. Now some drums. So there we go. When I started doing this looping thing, it was because, okay, hey, I sing, I write songs, I'm a beatboxer, I want to do all of this at once. I want the novelty part to fade away and for you to go, wow, that song really moved me. Grab you with these unique skills, and then once I've grabbed you, I want you to listen to my music. I don't think it's too limited. I mean, just because I use machines and looping doesn't mean, this is just the path I've taken. I mean, an artist like Scratch, or an artist like Rahzel, or an artist like Kela in the UK, or, you know, this is their art form, you know? This is my art form, and if I didn't have all these machines, I could go out and for 45 minutes entertain you with this microphone.
London er et av de viktigste sentra for human beatbox I verden. Her beatboxerne I større grad inspirert av andre musikkstiler enn hiphop, som drum and bass og dance. I en musikkforretning I London finner vi en av nåtidas mest særegne og spennende beatboxere. Shlomo drar nytte av en variert musikkbakgrunn.
My musical background is as a jazz drummer. Like, well, I've been classically trained as a percussionist since I was like 8 years old. And I was always playing in orchestras and things, playing the timpani. And then moved on to playing jazz when I was about 14. When I did kind of work out about beatboxing, I was not necessarily coming from the hip-hop background that other beatboxers have. But I mean, that's the beauty of making music with your mouth, is you don't have to be limited by anything. Like, you can just hear a groove and think, right, I'm going to do that with my mouth. You know, it's very open like that.
Yes, all the sounds came from the mouth. 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 Yes, all the sounds came from the mouth.
Basically, you've got a problem and you're trying to record the audio of a beatbox, right? And you're trying to make a record. If you watch the beatbox, you'd think, wow, that's amazing. But if you were to just listen to the music that he was making without any visual, you wouldn't really think much of the noise, because you wouldn't understand that it all came from his mouth, so there's that gimmick thing. So for years, for me, I was always like making recordings and always trying to squeeze in the whole, how impressive is this, it's all coming from my mouth, check it out. And it's only been recently that I've managed to chill out from that and just make music using my mouth, but also just not feeling limited by it. So it's like a starting point rather than just holding it back, do you know what I mean? So I've started jamming with loads of other musicians and treating it as an instrument, and then just making music in the same way that I used to before I even started beatboxing. I think that's the main challenge, is to come at it from a musical point of view and approach the whole thing as a musician rather than as an entertainer.
Nettopp Shlomos talent som musiker var noe av selveste Björk trengte til plata si Medulla, et album som bestod kun av vokal. Shlomo og Rahzel var blant de håndplukket artisterne som Björk hentet inn til prosjektet sitt.
When she contacted me, they were in London, they were mixing the album, and she said that I could try a few different things out.
Well, there's loads of stuff there that someone can sift through and take the... each sound they like the best and then replace the electro beat with them.
I'm wondering if it's worth it, because it sounds so great, because you're so, like, your style. Mm-hmm. Like, when I heard it on the web and when I hear you, mm-hmm. it's so light and mm-hmm. it's so, like, fast mm-hmm. and flickery.
Yeah.
Maybe we should have a go at just doing, like, a, I don't know, some, like a whole thing, you know, like
yeah,
a...
Yeah, let's do a take.
Yeah.
So I just went into the booth and I just tried out a whole lot of different vibes, different kind of rhythmic styles, and we kind of came up with one together. From Mother Oceania,
yearning to feed make prince. Låta Oceania med Shlomos rytme ble sett av flere millioner mennesker under åpningsseremonien I OL I Aten.
She was the first person who really did see his beatboxers as people who can make music and not just a thing to back up a rapper.
Something, I don't know, like a...
The triumph of the heart.
Just like maybe, you know, a jazz combo 40 years ago, you know, oh, they'd go and get the best bassist or the best trumpeter or the best saxophonist. Now, people like Rahzel, Scratch, they're being seen as, oh, this is someone I want to collaborate with. This is someone I want to bring onto my album. And, you know, this is a unique talent.
Stuff that
yeah thanks for coming
yeah. Storbritanniens store beatbox-stjerne skal opptre på en festival I London. Fansen venter spent på artisten som har blitt kalt pioner av Justin Timberlake og som har samarbeidet med Pharrell og Timberland. Killa Kela en beatbox-visionær med store ambisjoner.
You know, not only is it important to try and find new sounds that unlock kind of doors into making beatboxing more of a instrument in itself, but also come up with new, you know, concepts and ways of putting a different sound of music across, you know. Flash images, mixed messages,
subliminal, tools of distraction. På hitten Rave of the Future består trommebiten kun av Kellas beatbox.
When I did elocution, I was like, I always wanted my voice, my personality, the beatbox as a thread to be incorporated with other like vocal disciplines. You know, like spoken word, rapping, singing. Get instruments on stage that I couldn't do and set that as a soundscape for me to roll over and do the beats. It sets a new kind of stage and puts the beatbox in the forefront. Spider. Just take it further and let's put it up against instruments like string quartets and orchestras and the oboes and the flutes and the operatic singers, you know, let's put it up there and let's try and find a new sound that, you know, that doesn't replicate any other beatbox sound or replicate any other instrument other than the person that's doing it. How did I get it in the first place? Seems like I'm stuck on some space. Could this be the rave of the future? One, two. What you gotta do? that's, I think, how you go across and putting beatbox into a higher kind of status where it's not just a one-man show or a sideshow for a rapper. I think what beatbox has added is a certain amount of organic life to an industry now that is so kind of contrived. There's so much, like, you can never tell now whether something's real or it's been processed, or whether it's produced or overproduced, or whether it's real instruments. You just can't tell. So I think what beatbox adds is a certain organic sound that, and an unmistakable talent and rawness on stage that you just can't get from anywhere else.
It just sounds interesting. I mean, I find it fascinating that you can create music without instruments.
Artister som Justin Timberlake utnytter nå sounden og troverdigheten til human beatbox I karrieren sine. Timberlake bygger opp et image som urban artist ved å kvidre platene og live-opptredene sine med beatboxing. Den fremtredende både på det første soloalbumet Justified og den nyeste platen hans.
It's just become an art form now. I mean, there's people like, Scratch and Rahzel, and I mean, there's a whole handful of people who really do it well and can actually sound like drum machines. And that's where it's really become, like you said, interesting and fascinating. And
nye beatbox-talent dukker opp over hele verden, og I 2005 gikk tidenes første verdensmesterskap av stabelen I Tyskland. 15 nasjoner kjempet om VM-tittelen. I dommerpanelet satt blant andre Scratch, Killa, Kela og Kid Lucky. Finalebattlen sto mellom australske Joel Turner og Roxorloops fra Belgia. Go. Joel Turner ble historiens første verdensmester. Arrangementet I Leipzig markerte at det femte element står sterkere enn noen gang. Ikke bare som en del av hiphop-kulturen, men også som en selvstendig musikalsk kunstform.
Hiphop's never gonna die, beatboxing's never gonna die. It's always gonna be there on the street level, so even if it goes all the way back underground, it's still gonna be there, it's still gonna be part of kids' lives, you know?
Where do I want beatboxing to go? I want it to go to places that I never could have anticipated. Like, I wanted to go to places that I never would have thought of. Like, man, I can't believe he's doing that. I can't believe he brought beatboxing into that corner of the culture. Or, I can't believe he used that thing and that machine and that tree and that dog and that cloud and I don't know. Like, I hope that this art form will continue to be taken to places that I never could have anticipated. Beyond.